Hi, I'm Dr. Adeline Tan from University Malaysia, Sabah. This video clip is the second video clip to explain management in the course Fundamental of Entrepreneurial Acculturation. In this video clip, I will focus on leading and organizing, the two management functions. The learning outcome of this video clip first is to understand the management functions, organizing and leading. Understand the organizational structure and know the leadership styles and motivation factors. I will start with explaining organizing, the second management function. For organizing, actually, we are talking about how to organize the tasks and the people in the company. So when we talk about organizing, manager first has to determine which tasks needed to be done within a certain period of time. Or what to be do. Second, who will do it? Who are the workers? What type of workers are suitable to do that job? And last, how the task will be managed and coordinated. In organizing, there are many jobs that the manager has to do. First, the manager has to design the jobs. They have to determine what type of tasks that the workers have to do. And then the manager might determine to group the jobs together to build a team to work together. And next, they have to determine the reporting relationship. For example, a worker will report to the supervisor and supervisor will report to the manager. And at the same time, the manager has to determine the authority, or in other words, who to manage who. The manager will have authority to manage the supervisors, and the supervisor will have authority to manage the workers, to take care of the office, and so on. And the manager has to coordinate the work activities, making sure that no two person doing the same job and wasting their time. Last, the manager has to differentiate the job between the positions to ensure that people who are in certain positions should do certain job. The first very important task that in organization is to determine the job or to do job design. Job design is to organize tasks, duties, and responsibility into a production unit of work and match the characteristic of certain job. In another word, the manager will determine what type of jobs that the supervisor have to do, what are the responsibility of the supervisor, and then he has to determine what are the characteristics that suitable for supervisor. For example, supervisor must be people who can manage the workers, who can take care of their workers, and at the same time, he know what to do under certain situation. And at the same time, the manager has to determine what are the job performance expected for a certain worker, the satisfaction that might be facing by our workers, and the manager has to take care of the physical and mental health of a certain worker. After some time, the manager might decide to change the job of a worker. So the manager can do first job enlargement or expand the number of work tasks the worker can do, or to enrich the job to determine that the workers can be given more responsibility. For example, the workers now are given the responsibility to take care of the room. Extra responsibility. And last, the manager also can determine job rotation. For example, he can shift the person doing different job after a certain period of time to avoid the workers feeling so demotivated because of doing the same job again. Next, another important thing under organization is to determine the organizational structure of the company. There are four commonly used structure in the company. The most common is the functional structure, in which each department is divided based on the function they are doing. For example, the financial department, information technology department, human resources department, production department. While at the same time, the company can determine the structure based on the geographical position. For example, the European branch and the Asian branch. Or the company can determine the structure based on the products that they produce. For example, one team to take care of product A, another team take care of product B, and another team take care of product C. And at the same time, sometimes certain companies have matrix structure. Matrix structure means that a worker, for example, a production worker, report directly to a production manager, but at the same time, the production worker and marketing worker work together in a team and they report to a team leader, a different person. So a production worker might have two managers, one production manager and one team leader to report to in the organization. Next, I will look at leading. When we talk about leading, we are more looking at how to manage the workers, how to control the workers so that the worker will do their best to achieve the target of the company. When we talk about leading, we're looking at how to instill an enthusiasm by communicating with each other, how to motivate the workers to work harder, how to maintain good interpersonal relationship, good relationship between the workers and between the workers and the managers, build up commitments and enthusiasm among the workers, and then turn the plans into action. This is what we call leading. When we look at leading, bear in mind, when we talk about leading, leading is more emphasized on behavioral issues and focus on people rather than the job. When we talk about managing, managing is broader, and normally managing not focusing on behavioral issue only, but focusing on non-behavioral issue, also focusing on doing the job rather than people. And when we are manager, we have to bear in mind managers are different from leader. Leader is always more important than manager. When we talk about leaders, leaders always trying to grow the workers, make sure the workers grow up, rather than making the workers to work too hard. And as a leader, we try to appraise or we try to come up with plan B. We are trying to help the workers to work better, rather than we force them or we argue them, we scold them for not performing. And at the same time, leader, we always try to pull the workers to work to a higher position. And leaders always think that we work together rather than you or I am the best. Workers always think that we should work together. Next, workers also like leaders because leaders will always ask them, what you want? What do you expect? How can we work together? But boss will rather command them to work according to what they think. And for leaders, we'll say, let's do it together. We do it together. Rather than boss saying, you go and you work it yourself. This is the difference between manager and work leader. And when we look at leadership styles, there are many different leadership styles. One type of leadership style, we call it autocratic. That means leader will decide what to do next and the workers cannot say anything. This is autocratic. And the opposite of autocratic is laissez-faire. Leader will say, okay, you will determine, workers will determine what to do next. Okay, you will determine what to do next and then do this or that as you see fit. So workers will determine what to do next. And for democratic is workers and leaders will sit down together and determine what to do next. What should you think? What do you think we should do next? So they have two ways communication here. And there is another type of leadership. We call it paternalistic. Is the leader is like the father who take care of the workers. So this is quite suitable for Asian society. Quite suitable for Asian society. Next, we look at the staff motivation. When we talk about staff motivation, there are many ways to motivate the workers. There are financial ways. For example, we give them bonus, commission, profit sharing. But we have to bear in mind, this will come up with costs. And at the same time, we can motivate them using non-financial factors, for example, by setting up objectives, determine flexible working hours, give them paid holidays, give them appraisal awards, and allow them to participate in decision making and delegation. Non-financial work factors might work better for a certain type of workers. So we have to determine what type of factors we have to use at a certain period of time, because non-financial factors might be good at a certain period of time, but at the same time, we need financial factors to motivate them also. So this is the end of this video clip. For more information, please refer to my Schoology account, and also please go to e-commerce to create your profile if you have not created your profile yet. Thank you for watching this video clip.